came up after we went through the training, and then we came in and were expected to pick, you know, approve these appointments and all these committees. I kind of took that pretty seriously based on one thing. I think we're not representing the county as a whole unless we as commissioners actually go out and try to recruit people to be in these committees. I think that's, and I don't know how much that's being done. I know it wasn't done on my part, and that's where I kind of was with some of these appointments. I thought it was our job to find people to be on these committees to represent us as a board. And I thought that was one expected of us and kind of our rights as a commissioner. So I thought, how can I step into something and literally approve something that, one, I didn't know any of the people involved, and then two, a lot of times these committees covered things that there's money involved, taxpayer money. And I wanted to be certain that I was aware of all the parts of it and accountable for it. That was probably the major concern, is how accountable we are as a board for the actions of these committees. And I've learned a lot since then, and I have pretty strong views about not being able to coming in and disrupt the standpoint of what was going on. So what was the committees as they were. So that's kind of my feelings about the committee involvement. And we'll continue to work on it.
Yeah, I don't think there's any disagreement about the general aspect of this. An eminent grade engineer trying to edit something that sometimes gets a little confusing. So I think that by the next week we'll have a consensus with respect to the one.
Public discussion.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Okay. Tim Miller, Ponds and Plains Libraries. Like Bill, I'm from the bustling metropolis. They call Sima, downtown Sima. But our business address is 651 West Beverly Street. My board and I have a number of concerns about the policy as it potentially relates to us. We're not quite sure if and how it relates to us. So we have requested a commentary from our attorney. So I'm just going to ask this out to you here, if that's all right. And then I'm done.
Okay.
Thank you.
I didn't know you could afford an attorney if you didn't have late fees.
I think I can afford it.
Thank you.
Yeah. You just want to hand that out to where I'm going to make a comment, Tim?
No. Okay, that's good. Well, we'll review.
Bill Harris, 808 Caribou, Sima, Colorado. I looked at this draft, and I see one thing left out. Every time we have an election, I fill out a document to be an election judge. And I always get turned down. And so I took the liberty to go to Mr. Schroeder, and I said, how come I'm never selected? He said, you don't get along well with others. And I think that should be put in that draft as well. The people need to work together. And that's right, I don't get along well with others. I've been an independent too long. But I looked at that draft, and it's good that we have a senior statesman on board that looks at this with different eyeballs. And so, I appreciate the fact that you gentlemen are going to look at it more thoroughly and put it together. And thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you. And I do think a lot of what's in here, it seems to me to be generally common sense. If the language needs to be tweaked, we'll do that. But again, it's an effort to actually lay out publicly how we make appointments versus letting it be a mystery where people just appear.
Rick Brown, Kiowa. I appreciate the fact that this matter's been tabled. There's numerous problems with the draft that I can't cover in 3 minutes, but just what I can say is that there are various provisions are vague, ambiguous, in some cases incomprehensible. From a substantive standpoint, there's a few points I'd like to cover in the time I have. The first is the disqualification for Sioux County. In other words, it says in Sioux County, you're currently or formerly, you can't serve on the Board of Commission. This would cover somebody who, say, had a negligence claim because they were hit by a county vehicle and recovered a settlement or a judgment. Why would you want to exclude those people for something that's not their fault? It would also cover litigations over issues of public concern, such as lawsuits based on the Open Records Act or the Open Meetings Law. Now, you need to understand that in the First Amendment of the Constitution, the U.S. Constitution, there's a provision called the Petition Clause, which protects the right to petition the government for the redress of grievances. In my view, and the view of others, this covers litigation over public issues of public concern, and you're setting yourself up for future litigation if you adopt this portion of the policy. I should tell you that this particular provision has generated interest outside the county, and that the ACLU has been contacted about this issue and is currently looking at it. There's also a one committee limit in the policy. Now, I don't know if you need that kind of a provision actually codified in order to apply it from time to time. But what strikes me is that my impression, maybe I'm wrong, is that you're not really overwhelmed with qualified applicants for any of this position, for any of these positions. And it seems ill-advised. I hope it's not an effort to try to get disfavored individuals who may currently be serving on more than one board. With regard, there's implications here also for the Planning Commission. The Planning Commission has statutory qualifications limited to residency that are set forth in the Colorado revised statutes. Your own Elwood South County zoning regulations, Part 1, Section 2, have qualifications for planning commissioners that are limited to residency. I don't see, maybe it's there, but I haven't found a statutory authorization that allows you to embellish these qualifications through something like a litigation prohibition, for example. So the responsible course of action here is the one that you've taken. What I would suggest is that in addition to tabling the proposal, you have a work session, and a work session in which you take public comment. I know you don't normally do that at work sessions. I can tell you from my own experience on the Planning Commission when we considered the bylaws, we had work sessions that took public comment. Nobody died, and it was quite productive. So I suggest we be here. Thank you.
Thank you, Rick. Any other public comment? Get that far. Okay. All right. Now at this time we've got open motion to open a public hearing.
Yeah. So I'll move that we open a public hearing on the Celtic Festival special event permit for the consideration of the liquor license.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So we have a public hearing on the Celtic Festival special event permit. Dallas?
Governing Commissioners, Dallas Schroeder, Clerk and Recorder. In your packet provided to you was the application by the Elizabeth Celtic Festival Association for a special event permit for their annual event that they have at the Casey Jones Park. This year they're doing it on July 15th and 16th. They have submitted all the paperwork that's required. They submitted payment. This public hearing has been posted for the prior 10 days. And so everything is in order. Just waiting for your decision.
I move that we approve the Celtic Festival special event permit liquor license.
I'll
I'll second that, but I didn't have to say it.
I don't have that speech to you like that.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right, we exit the public hearing?
Yeah, move to close the hearing.
Close the hearing?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, at this time, let's go to, board planning.
You might want to announce that we don't have any land use.
Okay. No land use hearings. And as I think our agenda will indicate at the next meeting that our land use hearings will take place in the future at 1 p.m. Okay, so we'll have the board meeting initially, recess, and then our land use hearings will take place. All right, on to board planning. What do you have?
Thus far, we have on tap a presentation by Elizabeth Park and Recreation Board. Mike Barney is here for representing them. They just wanted to give that date to the board of what they're got going on there. We'll have approval of minutes from today. Centennial Mental Health Center would like to make a presentation. Also on that May 24th date.
Let me interrupt for just a second. You'll have the approval of the minutes for today plus the minutes from the Lionsgate.
Yes, they'll be 12. We're expecting to have, or at least hopefully put on there, a final decision on the site of the West Building. If not, we'll have to have a special meeting. There'll be a discussion with Sean Hearn, engineer, on roads, a conversation on the website update, further discussion on the employee handbook. As I understand it, there's a desire to have an expanding staff report and update on the planning review. We'll have that on there. The consent agenda will show the acknowledgement of the receipt of the variance report. There will be a discussion on the stabilization reserve fund, and I assume also then we'll have a discussion or an action item in the appointments policy that was just tabled.
There was one more, I think, that you might want to consider, and that is that at this point we're scheduling a meeting of the Planning Commission and the Board of County Commissioners as kind of a strategic planning thing that, well, I think we've got that tentatively scheduled for the 23rd of May.
Yeah.
And it, what we're planning on doing is just having everybody here in the room, it'll be public, and this will be the first time the county's going to buy us pizza as we discuss. And hopefully what we're going to, the outcome will be is that we will reach a viewpoint on how we're going to finish up the comprehensive plan, how we're going to finish up the water plan, how we're going to integrate that into the planning, zoning, and all of that rewrites. And just question each other of what our views of the future might be. There'll be no decisions made. It's just meant to be an informative meeting for all parties.
I would just say mention of the stabilization reserve fund, kind of we've floated around different terms, but essentially we have large projects like the wind farm that do bring in a large amount of money in a short period of time. There's a whole lot of requirements in this county that we can't fund on an ongoing basis. So in order to prevent the natural urge to actually spend money on stuff that we know we need to spend money on but may not be able to maintain for the long term, we want to set up and establish what we're going to call a stabilization reserve fund, something that can allow us over time to keep a steady level of services if we hit another economic downturn like we did. And we can't cut to 3 days of service. We can't just stop. We're pretty bare bones right now. We need to use this to develop more of a strategic reserve that keeps the county moving at a stable level through economic downturn. So, the money's from the wind farm is one place where we can devote a piece of that to ensure that we have a future that we can manage and we can fund it as certain
and fits it right in with the strategic plan also.
Yeah. All right. And entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.